Welcome. Today we will study Norton's theorem, which is to be used to solve circuit and network related problems. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to apply Norton's theorem to basic electronic circuits. Before starting with network theorem, that is Norton theorem, student should recall Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, series and parallel combination of passive circuit elements, voltage division, current division, star and delta connection, as well as source transformation. Now we'll see introduction to Norton's theorem. So basically, converse of Thevenin's theorem is Norton's theorem. Instead of equivalent voltage source in case of Thevenin's theorem, here it will consist of equivalent current source. Finding equivalent resistance of source network is same as done in Thevenin's theorem. However, in last step, to draw Norton's equivalent circuit, equivalent resistance of a source network is kept in parallel with current source. Now we'll see statement of Norton's theorem. A linear active network consisting of independent and or dependent voltage or current sources and linear bilateral network elements can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of a current source in parallel with a resistance, the current source being the short circuit current across the load terminal, and the resistance being the internal resistance of the source network looking through the open circuited load terminals. So, in Norton's theorem, the complicated circuit is to be replaced by equivalent current source in parallel with internal resistance. That internal resistance is similar to Thevenin's resistor, and that current is to be called as short-circuited current. Now we'll see one example related to Norton's theorem to understand how it is working. So this is the example: find the current in 5 ohm resistor of the circuit shown below. So in the circuit, there are two sources, that is independent sources. One is voltage source of 10 volt, another is current source of 1 ampere, and the 5 ohm resistor is there. So we have to find out current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor. Now first step is we have to remove 5 ohm resistor and we have to short those two terminals, that is X and Y, and current flowing through that short circuited branch is to be represented by ISC. So this is the first step in Norton's theorem. Now thing is, we have to find out ISC, short circuit current. So for that, we have to assume node voltage V at node 1. There are two nodes, node 1 and node 2. Node 2 is a reference node. And here, by applying nodal analysis, first of all, we have to find out value of voltage V. So, nodal analysis will give you the value of voltage V as given by equation, that is V minus 10 volt upon 3 plus V by 6 plus V by 10 minus 1 is equal to 0. So after solving this, we get value of node voltage V is equal to 7.22 volts. Next step is to find out ISC, we have to apply KVL, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law, at the loop, and the loop is 1, node point 1, node point X, node point Y, and node point 2. So by applying KVL at this loop, the equation we are getting is V minus ISC multiplied by 10 is equal to 0. Value of V we got at 7.22 minus 10 ISC is equal to 0. So from this, the value of ISC is equal to 0.722 amperes. Next step is we are going to find out equivalent resistance of source network. So to find Norton's equivalent resistor, which is to be represented by RNT through XY, that 5 ohm resistor is removed and all independent sources are deactivated. So we have to short circuit the branch consisting of 10 volts voltage source, and we have to delete the current source of 1 amperes. And looking through the XY terminals, we can find out RNT. So value of RNT is parallel combination of 3 ohm resistor with 6 ohm resistor, and this combination is in series with resistor of 10 ohm. So RNT is given by 3 parallel 6 plus 10. So from this we get value of RNT is equal to 12 ohms. Now last step in the Norton's theorem is we have to draw Norton's equivalent circuit, and across this we have to connect load resistor. In this case, the load resistor is to be represented by 5 ohm resistor, and as we have to find out the value of current flowing through 5 ohm resistor, here it is to be represented by I 5 ohm. So the figure shows equivalent circuit of Norton's theorem. So first, here it is current source, which is to be represented by ISC, and its value is 0.722 amperes. In parallel to this current source, there is its internal resistance or Norton's resistance, whose value is 12 ohm, and across this combination we have to connect, or we have to reconnect, the resistor of 5 ohm. Now to find out current flowing through resistor of 5 ohms, we have to use current division rule. So branch current or current flowing through 5 ohm resistor is I 5 ohm, total current is ISC, whose value is 0.722 amperes. So by current division rule, I 5 ohm is equal to ISC multiplied by RNT upon RNT plus 5. So if we put respective values, that is ISC is equal to 0.722 amperes and RNT is equal to 12 ohm, we get value of current I 5 ohm is equal to 0.5096 amperes. So like this you can solve a problem, or you can find out current flowing through a resistor by using Norton's theorem, and we have to use 4 steps. step one is you have to remove the resistor and you have to short circuit the branch, and current flowing through that short circuited branch is to be represented by ISC. We have to find out ISC by conventional network solving methods. After that, we have to remove the resistors, and looking from that side, we have to find out RNT, or internal resistance of the source network. To find out internal resistance of the source network, we have to deactivate independent sources. Independent voltage source is to be replaced by short circuit, and independent current source is to be replaced by open circuit. Last step is we have to draw equivalent network or Norton's equivalent circuit by connecting a source, current source, which is to be represented by ISC. Into that, we have to connect resistor in parallel, and across this combination, we have to connect or we have to reconnect load, and then by using current division rule, you can find out current flowing through respective resistor. The reference which I have used is Circuit Theory, Analysis and Synthesis by A. Chakraborty. Thank you.